I scouted, sir. They've locked the front, and I've seen evidence of snares. Also, maybe it's nothing, but I spotted several statues of the woman Delilah. I don't know what it means, but I thought it was worth mentioning.
It means trouble. Anything else?
They're getting in and out of the house somehow, but I haven't spotted it. Sorry, sir. Best I can do.
Good enough. I'll take it from here.
Strange doings, sir. I killed a hound in the yard, And it got straight back up and went for me. I had to crush its skull to be sure.
Ashes tonight.
Must be frightened.
Thank you.
Yeah. lever.
I see it. Another fool for the city.
Down, maybe. Should we go down?
Let him come up to us.
Thank you.
Delilah wants to use Emily to be Emily Caldwin.
Oh, toasty.
course.
They're more than statues. She's put her will in them. And in the void of power.
You have many talents, Dowd, and they've served you. Delilah's talents are quite different. She creates images, but she does more. She captures spirit. She insinuates her will into her subject, whatever it is. We're witnessing her masterpiece, and perhaps yours as well. I gave you Delilah's name, and you followed it to this moment. You see now what hangs in the balance. Emily's life, Delilah's ambition, an empire in the act of crumbling. In your long life, I've rarely seen you act with such consummate grace. I give my mark sparingly, and I don't play favorites. But I will watch this with unusual attention.
The Void? Time to see what you've really got, Delilah.
You've lived up to my expectations. Creeping in like a mouse. The mouse of Dunwall. I must say, I'm surprised you came this far. You're the one who gave me this chance in the first place. I thought I might see the Lord Protector pop up at the last minute. But never you.
I suspect Corvo's busy.
Are you doing this for Emily? Don't bother. You killed her mother in front of her and sold her to a gang of murderous crooks. You think she's fit for the throne? No. The girl Emily Caldwin will have the mind of Delilah the First, who did not inherit everything she got, but came to power through the force of her own genius.
Your genius couldn't keep me from reaching you. It won't save you now.
Who have your victims been, Dowd? Civil servants? The housekeeping staff? Drunken boys on watch duty and frail old aristocrats? None like me. Your mother should have taught you not to anger a witch. I'll kill you! But I'll smash you. Genius or...
Now!
conviction. Poor Jack. Foundry's heart was made of yes. All the time of the day.
No one will ever know exactly what it took to save Emily Caldwin from a living death as Delilah's puppet. No one except the outsider, who watches everything and thinks his own dark thoughts and speaks to few in any generation. I've learned that our choices always matter. To someone. Somewhere. And sooner or later, in ways we can't always fathom, the consequences come back to us. I came from Cirkonos to Dunwall as a boy, made my living as a killer, one of the few who've heard the outsider's voice. I murdered an empress, but saved her daughter, who will one day rule the Empire. Those were my choices. I'm ready for what comes. Inside me. Now I want nothing but to leave this city and fade from the memory of those who reside here. I've had enough killing. So my life is in your hands. Make your choice.
You make an eloquent plea for a man with innocent blood on his hands. It's a shame Corvo doesn't know the real story, isn't it? How in these last days you passed through Coldridge Prison like a shadow, dared the tangles of Dunwall's underworld, and walked out unscathed, outwitted one of the greatest witches in a generation, all with consummate care and skill. How you saved Emily Caldwin, daughter of the Empress, first of her name, and no one will ever know. But how does it end for Dowd, the hired killer, the murderer, the savior of the Empire? It's up to Corvo now.